In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to draw arcines. Now, this first question here, we're to draw the condensed structure and the line structure. Now, I'm going to start with the condensed structure. The first thing is look at the preface, which is this one. And the preface here says boots. Boots tells us that there are four carbons in this compound. So we'll write out all the four carbons connecting to each other. Okay, this is four carbons. Now, after writing out the four carbons, the next thing we need to do is to identify where the triple bond is located. Okay, so the triple bond in this case is located on the second carbon. So if we count from this side, we have one, two. It means that this is where we put our triple bonds. So the next thing we need to do is to fill up all our hydrogen to complete the bonds for carbon. Now for this carbon, it's connected to just one atom or one carbon. So it will need three hydrogens to make up four bonds. For this one, it has one, two, three, four. It's complete, so you don't need to put any hydrogen here. This one has one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. It's also complete. You don't need to put any hydrogen. Then for this one, you have just one connected to this carbon. So it means that you need to fill up three hydrogens to make it up four. Now here you have it, the condensed structure for boot two ion. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is to now draw the line structure. Now, we already know that this has four carbon. So when drawing a line structure, you would start by putting down a dot. That dot will be your first carbon. So that would be one, two, three, and four. So this is your one, two, three, four carbons. Now on the second carbon, you have your triple bond. This is the second carbon, so you put this there. Okay. Because this is a line structure, you don't need to put out all the hydrogens. So with this, your structure is complete. And of course, you don't need to number it. So this is the line structure for boot two ion. Okay. The next question is also to draw both the condensed structure and the line structure of 4,5-dimethylhept-1-ion. So I'll start with the condensed structure. We look at the roots. This is the roots. Okay. So this is a branch alkyne and it's different from what we first saw. That was a straight chain alkyne. The branched one, we have the branch represented in front of the root. So this is the root and hept here is telling us that we have seven carbons. So we draw out all the seven carbons connecting to each other. Two, three, four, five. So now we have our carbons drawn out. Here is telling us that we have the triple bond on the first carbon. So if I'm starting my counting from the left-hand side here, I'll have my triple bond here. Okay. So we have our roots drawn out. The next thing is to look at the branches. Here we have 4,5-dimethyl. This four is telling us that on the fourth carbon, we have one, two, three, four. We have one methyl group. Okay, so I add it there. Di means two of this. So on the fifth, which is this place, we have another one. So I write it out. Okay, so this has taken care of 4,5-dimethyl. Okay, so now we will then attach all our hydrogens to make up four bonds. on the carbons. So for this one, he has three bonds here. It means that there will be one hydrogen remaining. So I have one hydrogen. Okay. And on this other side, I have 1, 2, 3, 4. This is complete. We don't need to add anything. So we go over here. We have 1, 2. It needs 2 hydrogens to be complete. Okay. Then here we have 1, 2, 3. It needs 1 hydrogen to be complete 4. So we have 4 bonds now. Okay. Then here we have 1, 2, 3 bonds. We need 1 more bond. Here we have 1, 2. We need 2 more bonds, which is hydrogens in this case. And here we have 1. It needs 3 bonds, 3 hydrogens. Okay. So here we have 4,5-dimethylheptaneine condensed structure. Now, the next thing we need to then do is to draw out the line structure for this same compound. And the line structure would be starting with the dot here, we count. We are going for 7 carbons. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Just to confirm, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Good. Now we have our hept drawn out. The next thing is to now attach the triple bond, which is the 1I, and this is telling us it's on carbon 1. So we put our triple bond here. Okay. All right, so now we have the root drawn out. We then look at the branch. On the 4th carbon, you have here, you have 1 methyl group. And on the 5th carbon, you have another methyl group. And that is how a methyl group is represented with 1 stroke. So this is the line structure for 4,5-dimethylheptaneine. Okay, and the 3rd question here says to draw the condensed structure and the line structure of 2,5,6-trimethylnontriiene. To start, we first identify the root, which is non-triiene, and non tells us that there are 9 carbons in this compound. So we draw out all the 9 carbons connecting each other. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now we have all the 9 carbons drawn out. The next thing is to attach the triple bonds. And here it's telling us it's on the 3rd carbon. So 1, 2, 3. We put the triple bonds here. Okay. So after this, we then attach our branches. And here we have on the 2nd carbon and on the 5th carbon and on the 6th carbon, you have 3 methyl groups attached in each of those carbons here. So on the 2nd, we first put our methyl group. And on the 5th carbon, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On the 5th carbon, you have another methyl group. And on the 6th carbon, you have another methyl group. Okay. The next thing is to then fill out all the hydrogen, making sure that carbon has complete 4 bonds. Okay. So we have here, we have just 1 bond. So we have to put 3 hydrogens. Okay. Here we have 1, 2, 3, remaining 1 hydrogen. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, complete. Another 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, complete. So these 2 does not require hydrogen because the bonds are complete 4. Okay. So here we have 1, 2, 3, then 1 here to complete 4. The same thing happens here. 1 to make it 4. We have 2 here, so we need 2 hydrogens to make it up four. We have two here, two hydrogens to make it up four. And here you just have one, so we have to add three hydrogens. So here you have it, the structure of 2,5,6 trimethyl non-3-ion. Now we'll draw the line structure. Okay, so for the line structure, we'll start with a dot as usual. This will be your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And confirm that what you counted is correct by physically writing out the numbers. So this is correct. Okay, so after writing out the roots in line structure and confirming that the number of carbons is complete, we then attach our triple bond, which here is on the top carbon. So this is 1, 2, 3. So if this is 3, you attach your triple bonds on this side. Okay, now our branches is the next. We have 2,5,6 trimethyl. So on the second carbon, you have a methyl group that is 1, 2. You have a methyl group. On the fifth carbon, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have another methyl group. On the sixth carbon, which is this, you have another methyl group. So this is the line structure of 2,5,6 trimethyl non-3-ion. Thank you for watching. If this has been of any help to you, please subscribe, like, and comment, and see you in my next video.